Good morning, students. This is the class for 7th of May. Now we are going to start here with the match the followings, okay, and filling the blanks. Match the followings. We'll just have a quick look. Cows and grubs are herbivores. Skin is a sense organ. Animals walk on legs, and plants are called producers. So this is the filling, the match the following from the textbook. Now we'll also have a look at the filling the blanks. So I've given you 9 filling the blanks, all of which are important and to be learned, written in the notebook as well. But 1 to 5 are given in the textbook, and the remaining I have given considering that they are important. चेक कर लो पहले, कोई नहीं बोल दे। We'll just go through the filling the blanks very quickly. So new babies are produced from other organisms, and this process is called as reproduction. I have done this in the previous chapter as well, living and non-living things. Human beings have 5 sense organs. Insects and birds, they use their wings to fly. Grasshoppers breathe through spiracles. Plants use carbon dioxide from atmosphere. Frogs hop on the land and in water. Frogs hop on land and in water move by using their hind limbs. Ducks and swan can move in water by using their webbed feet. Fishes swim with the help of their tail and fins. Lizards crawl against ground or wall. Alright, so this is the end of class for today. This is the end of the notes for today. And we will also look into the revision of the chapter. So last class I have stopped the revision till here. What are the different eating habits of plants, animals? So we know that there are 3 types of animals: carnivores, herbivores, omnivores. And also one more thing you should remember, that plants are the primary producers. They make their own food, but however animals are dependent on plants or other animals for food. Now let's move on to the next topic for revision purpose. How do the animals they breathe? Animals they breathe by, just a second, just give me a second, I'll reduce the zoom size so that the entire page can be seen. Alright, animals they breathe by lungs, gills or air holes. Fishes they breathe through their gills. Plants have stomata, and in the humans they make use of lungs to breathe. Insects have air holes, or as I say, spiracles. Alright, then sense organs. There are 5 sense organs. What is the use of these sense organs? Let's see. So ears are used to listen, hear the sound. Eyes are for detecting light. Nose is for smell. Skin is for touch, and tongue is for taste. Now another characteristic of animals is that they reproduce. They give birth to the young ones by laying eggs or by giving birth. Okay, like dogs give birth to puppies. So a young one of a dog or a baby of the dog is called as puppy. Mother gives birth to a baby. Cow gives birth to a calf. Birds, they lay eggs. So there are 3 main ways in which plants and animals are interdependent on each other. The main one is that plants are the primary source of food for animals. Animals cannot make their own food, and they are dependent on plants or other animals for their survival. Then plants are providing shelter. Okay, so in these trees and all, you can see that animals, birds are living. Plants, they provide oxygen. How do they provide oxygen? During the process of photosynthesis, oxygen is released into the atmosphere. Remember this. And humans, we use what to breathe? We need oxygen. So animals, plants, they give out this oxygen, and animals use this oxygen to breathe in, and also humans, they use this oxygen to breathe in. Humans and bears are example of herbivore, carnivore or omnivore. So they are example of, they are example of omnivore. Skin, tongue, nose helps animals to perceive what taste. So tongue, cat gives birth to kitten. New words which we learned in this chapter were lungs and reproduction. You obviously know what is lung. Lungs are located in the chest. Okay, they are a breathing organ and they are located in the chest and they remove the carbon dioxide from the blood and bring the oxygen to the blood. So basically the air that you breathe in, okay, it ensures lungs help to take inside the oxygen and give out the carbon dioxide. Because see, you know, air is a mixture of gases. We did this in earth, our home. What are the three main components of air in the earth? Air, it could be oxygen, nitrogen and other gases. Within the other gases, we are considering carbon dioxide. So what happens is when I breathe the air, it has oxygen and carbon dioxide both. So what is my lung doing? My lung is ensuring that I take in my oxygen and I give out the carbon dioxide. So it is the breathing organs which are present within the chest which removes the oxygen from the blood and brings the which removes the carbon dioxide from the blood and brings the oxygen to the blood. Okay, so when I breathe in, I take both the components, but my lungs are helping me to ensure that oxygen reaches the blood and carbon dioxide is removed from the blood. What is reproduction? It is the process by which animals give birth to the babies. All right, so looking at the exercises we have done part A and we have done part C. Sorry, we have done part B as well. Part C we will be taking up tomorrow, and I also part D I will take up tomorrow. But I just want to tell you that we have also completed part E, which is filling the blanks. Okay, all right, students. So you know your homework for today. So you have to complete the notes still here. Okay, all the filling the blanks are important. The ones that I have given and the ones that are given in the textbook, all are important. You have to write down all of them. All right, students. Thank you.